Markers in Final Cut Pro 10 are great for identifying specific areas that need work. Keyboard shortcuts make them even faster. To add a marker to a clip on the primary storyline, you don't need to select it first. It will be added to any clip that has the active ball indicator on it. So here, to add a marker, I can just tap the M key. Tapping the M key again opens that marker so I can edit it. I'll call this one Check Color Correction. I'll also change this marker type to a to-do marker, and then hit return. If the playhead is over a connected clip, the marker will be added to that connected clip. I'll undo that. To add the marker to a clip on the primary storyline underneath a connected clip, you can tap the C key and then tap N, and I'll undo that. To add a marker to any clip under the playhead, hold the Command key down and tap the down arrow to get to the clip you want, and then tap the M key, and I'll undo that. An even better way to add a marker, rather than adding it and then opening it, is to press Option M, which will both add the marker and open it for editing. I'll say replace this shot and also change it to a to-do marker. And I'll add one more marker here without identifying it. Once you've added markers to your project, the timeline index becomes very useful. Shift-Command-2 to open it. I'll select Tags. And by default, everything is selected, so we see all of our keyword collections. But we can choose to look at regular markers. Selecting any of them will jump to that marker in the timeline. Or we can look at our incomplete to-to items. I'll make this comma a little wider. And selecting either of those jumps right to that marker. So they're great for producer notes or your own notes when you identify things you need to change but you don't want to do it right at the time. You can then go through the timeline index, select each of these, and make your changes. Once your changes are complete, clicking on this area of the marker moves it from incomplete to completed. The marker color changes to green in the timeline, and if you go to the completed markers section of the timeline index, you'll see it here. So once completed, you can go back and check your work. Markers are also useful for cutting to the beat in video. Here I have a music track, and I want to use markers to identify key beat points to cut to. So I'll start playback and tap the M key to the beat. Once my markers are in place, I've zoomed in a little bit here. I'll tap S to enable skimming. I'll tap Shift S to disable audio skimming because we don't need to hear anything. I just want to be able to skim here. And I'll also tap the N key to enable snapping so that I snap to each of these markers. Once I've done that, it's very easy to snap to a marker. I don't even need to worry about the playhead location. I'll snap to a marker, tap I, snap to another marker, tap O. And then I can begin to cut in my video to exactly match these beat points. I'll move the cursor over this clip. I don't even need to select it and press Q to edit it in. Now I've set my clip appearance to be audio only. I can change that now with Command Option and up and down arrow. I, O, skim in the browser, and Q. I, O, skim in the browser, and Q. I can very quickly begin to identify key beat points that I want to include in the video. Now, usually at some point, I want to start taking advantage of the magnetic timeline when I want to reorganize my shots or trim them or move them beyond the beat, because I don't always want to cut directly to the beat. So after I've established some anchor clips on exactly where I want them to be on the beat, what I'll usually do is select these connected clips, then press Option Command down arrow to move them to the primary storyline. Doing so automatically moves my music track down as a connected clip to a gap clip at the beginning. Now, because my clips are on the primary storyline, it's easy for me to reorganize them, and I can still use these gap clips in order to do replace edits. For instance, I'll skim to this gap clip, press Command-B to blade it, and now I can do a replace edit on the gap clip under the playhead by skimming to the clip I want to use and pressing Option-R. So I can take advantage of markers by editing as connected clips, and then by editing as part of the primary storyline. Click the subscribe button below. If you have an idea, comment, or suggestion, leave those below as well. Go to rippletraining.com for fast professional training on Final Cut Pro, Motion, and DaVinci Resolve from industry professionals.